Hey everyone, how are you? So I am super excited because we have finally gotten to the last tip of the how to cope with a toxic work environment while you create an exit plan. Tip number three of three. And oh my goodness, I am so sad that this series of tips is coming to an end. But it is the beginning of something incredibly exciting and new, which is my Jumpstart the Work You Love group program. It actually launched last week, but it is not too late to join us. So if you want to find out more information about that program, you can visit workyoulovenow.com/jumpstart. We've got a great group. It's a nice, small, intimate group of people who are trying to get, you know, the foundations of their careers together, figure out what their core desired feeling. Guys, that is my foundation for everything I do. So that we can use our core desired feeling as a compass, you know. Hey, you know, beyond what your core desired feeling is, what is your ideal work environment? Talking about physical, spiritual, emotional, you know, the whole nine yards. What type of work, physical location? We talk about your calling. What is your purpose? I help who? Like blank do blank. And then we create a plan in this program. This is literally how to create your exit plan and how to make sure it is the right place. But we are on the last tip of the three tips that I'm sharing about being in a toxic work environment and how you cope while you're in it. So the third tip is to do what I love to call, I actually just came up with this name, so I'm very proud of it, the post-it pause. I'm sure for those of you guys who have been following me for quite some time now, you've probably seen it. So there's also no point in time on there. You can see it's just a figure eight drawn over and over and over again. Now, what's incredibly important about this tip is if you're feeling maybe anger rise up in you, or you're feeling the tears well up, or you're just feeling incredibly freaking frustrated with your work environment, what's great about the post-it pause is that it allows you to have a mindfulness practice in an incredibly chaotic environment. It also allows you to have a mindfulness practice where it is discreet. So people aren't gonna judge you for sitting quietly with your eyes closed, and it seems kind of weird, right? So it looks like you're taking a note. But in fact, you're really focusing in on being mindful, coming back to the present moment where everything is just fine. Hey, Christina. So what I recommend for the post-it pause is to, so we have our figure eight, which where's the camera? We have our figure eight here. But what we want to do is you want to make the top of the eight the inhale and the bottom of the eight our exhale. Hi, Lauren. How have you been? It's been a while. So what we can do is we actually maybe I'll just point my camera down here is we inhale to the top of the eight and we exhale to the bottom. So and we try to make our breath as even as possible. And we do this over and over again until we find a sense of calm or a sense of ease or a sense that our frustration and anger is starting to diminish, and then we return to work. Because I'm sure I've said this in my last two tip videos, but when we're in a toxic work environment, when we're struggling, the one of the first things to go is our character and our emotional stability. So if we can basically maintain a clear mindset, we can be the person that we want to be even in difficult situations. So a tool like this can really be a game changer if you have 10 seconds, 5 seconds, just enough time for a few breaths to reconnect with the present moment. Being emotionally clear enables you to make better decisions and is going to create a solid foundation. Even if this is a toxic job, this toxic job can create a solid foundation as a stepping stone to the next and better job. If we let our emotions, our frustrations, our, you know, everything get in the way, we might act in a way that's going to cause consequences and cause consequences in a way that we, you know, that is going to affect us and our career. And we don't want that. So clarity of mind is incredibly clear. So try out the post-it pause next time you're feeling overwhelmed at work. It's really discreet. It's a really great mindfulness practice. Especially for beginners, the ones who are fidgety skeptics, as Dan Harris likes to say. Great, great, great tip. For those of you who feel like you identify with being in a toxic work environment, that is where drama, infighting get in the way of productivity. You know, maybe you're being bullied, maybe you're doing the work of an entire team, maybe, you know, I could go on. There's a lot of different things that define a toxic work environment. If you're feeling like you're in that space right now, I've launched a group program. I talked about it in the beginning of this video briefly, called Jumpstart the Work You Love. It's a small group of 5 to 8 people that are really looking to build their career from the ground up. What is our core desire feeling? What is our ideal work environment, physical, spiritual, emotional, and geographically? Like all of those, we take that into consideration. We take into consideration what is your calling, whether it's your calling right now or your overall calling. Who are you supposed to help? What are you supposed to be doing? And then we create a plan that is easy and actionable that you're actually going to do, you're actually motivated to do, because you have the real motivation, your core desired feeling, your real why. So this is a short 4-week program. It's happening every Thursday in September. It's not too late to join us. Make sure you go to workyoulovenow.com/jumpstart if you want to find out more information about the classes and when we're meeting. And I hope to see you all soon. Bye, guys.